Good morning and welcome to St. David's, and thank you for joining us this morning for our online worship service. With the provincial move to orange phase, we will continue to worship online until we return to yellow. Your safety and health is our first priority. If anyone needs anything at any time, please reach out to us. We are here to support you however we can during this challenging time. I welcome you to worship online this morning. God gathers us to worship. You are each a gift and a true blessing. As we worship today, I ask you to hold in our prayers the individuals who are ill, those who are in isolation, those who are worried, and their family members. We ask that God can offer peace to their hearts and hope and encouragement to their spirits and to our spirits. We also pray for public health officials and medical community, provincial leaders. We lift up prayers for ourselves, our family, our friends, our community, our province, and the world. A reminder to all of us during this challenging time to show love and compassion to others and to be a light. We gather as a community of seekers looking for the light that will give us clarity, the light that will guide our way, the light that is in our daily lives. We light this candle to remind us the light of Christ shines upon us each and every day. Our opening song this morning is "Here I Am, Lord."
I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in deepest sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. Pain. I have wept for love of them, they turn away. I will break their hearts of stone, give them hearts for love alone. I will speak my word to them, whom shall I send? I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will tend the poor and lame. I will set a feast for them. My hand will save. Finest bread I will provide, till their hearts be satisfied. I will speak my word to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go.
God, you call each of us to serve you, and we answer,
Here I am.
Jesus, you call each of us to follow you, and we answer,
Here I am.
Holy Spirit, you call each of us to worship you this day, and we answer,
Here I am.
I have already answered, and when you call for me, I am already there. And when you call for me, I have already answered, and when you call.
Loving God, you call to us today, just as you called to Samuel so long ago. Gathered here, we are many different ages, but we pray for the maturity of faith to hear your call and respond to your word. Open our ears and our hearts as we worship, as we work, and as we care for one another. We ask that you would give us courage and integrity to answer your call with the heartfelt words, Here I am. Amen.
And when you call for me, I have already answered. And when you call,
at the beginning of the school year, most teachers will make a name tag for each student in the class. The teacher does this to be able to help the students in the class learn one another's names. From time to time, we do that here at church as well. We make sure that everybody has a name tag so everyone will get to know everyone's name. Your name is very important to you, isn't it? Doesn't it make you feel good when people know your name and remember your name? Do you think God knows your name? I am sure that God does. Names are very important to God. In fact, I can think of many times in the Bible when God calls somebody by name. One of my favorite stories in the Bible is the story of a boy named Samuel, which we're going to hear in a few minutes. Some people think that God only calls grown-ups. That is why I like the story of Samuel. Samuel was a young boy when God called him. God knows your name, just as God knew the name of Samuel, and God still calls children today, saying, "Come, follow me." So listen for God's call and answer, just as Samuel did. Here I am. Let us just pray. Dear God, today we are listening for your call. Perhaps you have something special for us to do. When you call, we will answer, "Here I am." Amen.
Our scripture reading this morning comes from the first book of Samuel, chapter 3, beginning at the first verse. Now the boy Samuel was ministering to the Lord under Eli. The word of the Lord was rare in those days. Visions were not widespread. At that time, Eli, whose eyesight had begun to grow dim so that he could not see, was lying down in his room. The lamp of God had not yet gone out, and Samuel was lying down in the temple of the Lord, where the ark of God was. Then the Lord called, "Samuel! Samuel!" And he said, "Here I am," and ran to Eli, and said, "Here I am, for you have called me." But he said, "I did not call. Lie down again." So he went and lay down. The Lord called again, "Samuel!" Samuel got up and went to Eli and said, "Here I am, for you have called me." But he said, "I did not call, my son. Lie down again." Now Samuel did not yet know the Lord, and the word of the Lord had not been yet revealed to him. The Lord called Samuel again a third time, and he got up and went to Eli and said, "Here I am, for you have called me." Then Eli perceived that the Lord was calling the boy. Therefore Eli said to Samuel, "Go lie down, and if he calls you, you shall say, 'Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening.'" So Samuel went and lay down in his place. Now the Lord came and stood there, calling as before, "Samuel! Samuel!" And Samuel said, "Speak, for your servant is listening." This is the word of God.
Thanks be to God. Our lives are full of noise. Technical devices that buzz and beep and ring and ping to catch our attention and to take us away from whatever we may be doing. Interruptions define our daily living. Our brains focus quickly on one topic, then switch to another and then to another. It's almost like we are constantly on overload. But with all those interruptions, we find it hard to resist that blinking light on our phone indicating we have a new message, or that vibration of our watch telling us that there is a new message. Studies have found that a high school student can't go more than 2 minutes without becoming distracted by social media, whether it be Twitter, emails, Instagram, text, or Facebook. But it's not just the younger people. People everywhere seem to be experiencing an epidemic of overwhelm. According to studies, the average business person receives and sends about 109 emails a day. And that rate is growing each year by 7%. Think of that, 109 emails a day. How much time is spent sending and receiving those messages? Instant messages are increasing, and texting is bombarding everyone. The surge of text and social media notifications in recent years is giving many of us this terminal distraction and always-on availability. The idea that we are supposed to be able to monitor all this stuff and keep a handle on what God is up to at the same time seems totally absurd. Some people say such things as, "My life is lived on the internet." With all these interruptions and distractions, how in the world are people supposed to be able to listen and hear the voice of God? In our scripture reading that we heard this morning, it says that the Lord's word was rare in that time and visions weren't widely known. What I think the writer of 1 Samuel is trying to tell us is that people weren't listening. God was talking, nudging people all the time. It wasn't that God wasn't sending out visions or God's word, it's that people weren't hearing God. And isn't that what is going on today? God is always speaking, calling, and nudging. But do we take time to listen to God's call? Or does it feel like the Lord's word is rare and visions aren't widely known? There is so much going on in the world around us, and some people may just throw their hands up in the air and say, "Where is God in all of this?" If you listen to the news enough, it can become stressful and it can become difficult to slow down and listen for God. But isn't that exactly what we need to be doing? If we can't hear God, what hope do we have? Is it all meaningless, or was there meaning? Is there a purpose? Is there a reason for it? Hannah, Samuel's mother, was at the end of her rope. She was not able to have children, and she very much wanted to be a mother. She took a chance. She promised God that if she could have a son, she would dedicate her son to God's service. She had a son. She named him Samuel, which means God heard. She kept her promise to God, and Samuel grew up in the temple from a very young age. He lived in the temple, slept in the temple, and helped the high priest Eli take care of the temple. He was a full-time altar boy. The Bible says Samuel slept in the same room as the Ark of God, the Ark of the Covenant. The Ark of the Covenant was where the power of God was most present. He was about 12 years old at the time. When God first called Samuel, he thought it was Eli who was calling. He wasn't expecting God to speak. He hadn't been listening for God. It just wasn't something people did. But finally, Eli realized it was the Lord calling the boy. Then Samuel went back and laid down and waited and listened carefully for God's voice. Sometimes family, friends, mentors, Sunday school teachers, youth leaders, and ministers can point us to God's voice. But other times, it might be something else. Maybe it's a homeless person on the side of the road. Maybe it's someone who is facing a very challenging time. Maybe it's through an act of kindness. Or a door we open to God, a commitment on our part to do the right thing, and before we know it, God's voice is booming in our hearts and in our minds. In any event, when Eli told Samuel that God was calling him, he became expectant. He was ready to hear. How can we be ready to hear? What can we do to be prepared to hear God's call? We are told that the Lord came and stood there calling just as before, "Samuel, Samuel." Notice the words, "just as before." Not in some new way, but in this way that God had been calling all along, and God is always calling. This time, when God called Samuel, said, "Speak, your servant is listening." How many of us really want to hear God's voice? Let's be honest. It can be risky to ask God to speak, and it changes our lives if we listen. Because no matter the details of the call, God always calls us away from self and selfishness and into a new life in love for God and neighbor. If we heed the call of God, we will never be the same again. But isn't that what life is all about? Do you want to know the will of God for your life, your every moment? Do you want to love God and other people? Do you want to live the way that God intends for you to live? Do you want to do the good that God has prepared in advance for you to do? And do you want to be free to do that? And I don't think we can do this very well if we are caught up in the "what's in it for me" attitude, or "how will this benefit me?" God isn't a commodity, neither are people. Studies show that listening doesn't come naturally to most people and can often be a problem. Ever been ready for some rebuttal to what someone is saying without really listening to what they are saying? We aren't always good listeners. And it's a problem in that relationships we have with other people. So just imagine what a problem it is when it comes to having a relationship with God. Notice in the reading that we heard, they don't say Samuel went to sleep after God was about to speak to him, but it seems to imply he lay in his bed and thought about what God had told him. He meditated on God's word, and then when the time came, he spoke about God's word to Eli and later to all of Israel. He took the time to digest what God had told him and then proved the truth of God's word by putting it into practice. Clearly, the emphasis of 1 Samuel chapter 3 is on listening. What are you listening to? Who are you listening to? There is a lot of noise around us, and it would seem that there are a lot of people who have no interest in really hearing God. But God's word is everywhere. It's all around us. It's alive and it's kicking. What we need to do is listen. Let us not get distracted with all of the sounds of all of the devices, all of the messages coming in. We need to listen to what God is saying. And when we act on what we hear from God, our world changes. We are transformed. And the word of God speaks through us, and whether it be in actions or only in audible words, it doesn't fail. Listen for God's calling. Amen. God's blessings are all around us. The ministries of St. David's continue to live our call through worship, through pastoral care, through prayer, and through outreach. And we give thanks to each of you for your continued support of the ministries of our church. We ask for God's blessings on the gifts received by plate, by par, by e-transfer, and for blessings on us and the various ministries and activities that we provide and continue to journey to be your people in this world. Amen. Let us just take a few moments this day and put aside the sounds that are distracting us. Quiet our hearts and our minds, and take time to spend in prayer. We come to you, God, after another week of activity and ministry. We pray that your blessings would continue to shower down upon us and all that we do. We give you thanks for winter weather and the beauty of snow. They are the work of your hand. Be with those, whoever, who find the cold and snow difficult to deal with, and search each day for a warm place to sleep and food to eat. We lift up in prayer those who grieve. Give them comfort in their sadness and peace in the midst of anxiety. Bless them with an inner healing that only your Spirit can provide. We keep in mind especially all those who mourn the loss of health, or a loved one, or a relationship, or a job, or financial security. You, God, are the one who brings wholeness to brokenness and hope out of despair. We trust you to do that for us today. We pray for those who are sick, for those in hospital. Be with everyone who is suffering from and by the pandemic that has effects on everyone. God, we want to always keep the priorities of our lives in proper order and balance, choosing your will and purpose over our own. Help us to always remember that we have a purpose and reason for being here. Help us to understand more of that purpose and how we might fulfill it more completely. Finally, God, we pray that you would give us bold hearts to share your good news. Often we're timid and hesitant to share our faith and to listen for your call. We need your encouragement. There are other times when we are arrogant and insensitive, and at those times we need your gentleness and compassion. Give us, God, the tools that we need to share the messages and lead others to this life. Hear our prayers and the prayers of all your people as we join in the prayer that Jesus taught us to say. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Our closing song this morning is I Have Called You by Your Name. Let us go in the knowledge that God is holding your life even as we hold each other. The God who calls you also goes with you. You are not alone. You are loved. Amen.
Never be afraid. God will go with you each hour of every day. Go now in faith, steadfast trust.
true.